So there's a new kid on the block. It's called coronary CTA, or CTA, or CT angiography. If you look at things like the PROMISE trial or the Scott-Heart trial, they show a lot of promise with this. And as you begin to look at these images, you see, gosh, yeah, those are really nice images. In fact, at this point, I've had several conversations with several patients who have these, and here's what they tell me. They say, you know what? It's great. I put a copy of it on my refrigerator door. So now when I go in to start thinking about getting a snack, maybe don't really need, this helps motivate me and helps me understand. Now, when you actually start looking at the science itself, it makes a case for the same thing. So what happened, for example, with the Scott-Heart trial was this. Here's what they did. They randomized people to doing whatever they did for a standard the cardiologist was used to. And as we know, that's almost always going to be some kind of stress test, usually nuclear stress test, followed by angiography. But what they did on these trials, like the Scott-Heart trial, was they said, go ahead and do what you normally do, cardiologist. However, add for the study group, add CT angiogram. And for the others, don't. Well, what happened was, as you can see here, this is really good at showing pathology, showing that you have plaque. So the people that were in the study group, they got the CT angiogram. In the beginning, they were listed as having a lot more pathology. They knew from the randomization procedure, and they knew from what was, you know, just from understanding what we've just discussed, they really didn't. That was a randomization issue, but it was just much more obvious because of the CT angiogram. So were there a lot more procedures? A little bit more procedures in the beginning with the CT angiogram patients. But over a five-year period, that all equaled out, and there were the same number of procedures, the same number of everything else from the medical side, but still there was a significant decrease repeat heart attacks for the folks that had the CT angiogram. Any ideas why that might have happened? Again, think about it. Go back to the story about patients. Gosh, I've got a significant plaque. I'm going to put that on my door. That's what happened. These patients that actually had this understood very well that they had significant plaque. They could see it. It was right there in front of their eyes. Major motivator for improving lifestyle. Other folks, on the other hand, get a stress test, things like that. They really don't get as good a picture of just what's going on inside their arteries. So, and in fact, quite often they'll get false negative stress tests. Up to a third of the negative stress tests are false as well. So again, you just depend on stress tests. You're likely to say, you know what? I'm glad I got over that and I didn't have a problem. You got to be feeling lucky to do that. A negative stress test, just like a positive stress test, they're not that reliable. Why wait for a disease and hope for a cure? I used to be an ER doc. My name is Ford Brewer. I quit ER after a few years because it was just so frustrating. Most of the things bringing people into the ER are things that should have been prevented, including heart attack, stroke, number one cause of death, number one cause of permanent disability. People think that you're just going to have those and that they're not predictable. Both of those are wrong. They are predictable and you don't have to have them. Usually it's lifestyle. Lifestyle is more important than supplements and even prescription drugs and even stents and surgery. But the current times are tough. Major financial impact with the lockdowns that most states have been going through. We've been working on a way to make this much more affordable with a subscription process. And that's exactly what we're announcing today. We've got two levels. One is the Silver membership, where you get access to our courses, a private webinar each month, and access to our supplement store and supplement recommendations and prescription. Or I would suggest even more so, the Gold membership. You can get a script for a freestyle Libre and find out what your blood sugar metabolism's doing on a daily basis. And you can get a lab order for inflammation, OGTT, and insulin survey. You can also get a 30-minute one-on-one with me. So I'm looking forward to seeing you. Cost is no longer an excuse. So if you're interested, go to go.prevmedheartrisk.com/prevmed-subscription or call us at 859-721-1414, 859-721-1414, or email us at myhealth@prevmedheartrisk.com. Looking forward to seeing you. Thank you.